In this video, I'll tell you the answer of a burning question, that is how to calculate power consumption. I'm asked this question many times in Quora. So I have decided to make a video on this and tell everyone that follow this video. So if you watch this video till the end, then some concepts of yours will be clear. Like you can, you'll be able to calculate your electric bill, and you will be able to calculate the battery runtime in case of your project. If you are using battery in your project, that will also be cleared. So let's start with the fundamentals. So I have decided to make this video in two parts. First, I'll discuss the consumption of household. Then I'll discuss the consumption of a battery driven circuit. So let's start with household. So if you want to calculate consumption in your home, then that is driven by a formula. You have to know this formula, that is you have to know load rating in watts. If you don't know what is load, then follow our video on load. We have made already a video on this, so you can follow that. You have to know the load rating in watts. So the load rating in watts will be multiplied by the load runtime in hours. Then you will get an energy rating in watt hour. And remember that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 unit. So whatever electric bill you are getting from your electric distribution company, they'll be charged based on the unit consumed. So you should know that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 unit. So let me give you an example. I have taken almost every loads you can have in your household. So one load is lamp of 40 watt. Normally the tube lights are of 40 watt. Ceiling fans are available with 60 watt. So I have taken ceiling fan of 60 watt. If you have a 43 inch LED TV, that will consume 60 watt of power. If you have 180 liters of refrigerator, it will be near to 200 watt. So I have taken 220 watt. And air conditioner is of 1700 watt. 1.5 ton 3-star AC will take this amount of power. If you are running a desktop computer, it will consume 100 watts of power, and for laptop it will consume 40 watts. These are all approximations. So suppose you are using these loads, then you should know the load runtime. So I have taken the approximate runtime. Suppose you are the lamp is on in your household for 8 hours, ceiling fan is running for 8 hours, TV you are watching for 4 hours, your refrigerator is running for 12 hours. Most of the household, they run a refrigerator all the time. Air conditioner is running for 6 hours. Desktop computer is on for 10 hours. And you are running a laptop for 8 hours. So in your household, this is very unlikely that you will have only one lamp. So I have mentioned the quantity. I have assumed that if there are 5 lamps, then what will happen? So like that way, I have taken 5 lamps, 4 fans, 1 TV, 1 fridge, 1 AC, 1 desktop computer and 1 laptop. So then the formula will be, and the total energy will be load into time in hours into quantity. So in first case, the total energy will be 40 into 8 into 5, because there are 5 lamps running for 8 hours each. So the total energy consumed will be 40 into 40, 1600. And for ceiling fan, it will be 32 into 60, 1920 watts. For TV, it will be 240 watts. For refrigerator, it will be 2640 watts. For AC, it will be much bigger than all the loads. That will be 10,200 watts. Desktop computer, it will be 1000 watts. and for laptop it will be 320 watts. You can pause the video and open a calculator in your mobile and calculate and add all the energy consumption. Then you will find the total energy is equal to 17,920, and the energy unit is watt hour. If I want to convert it into kilowatt hour, then I have to divide it by 1000. So after doing that, I'm getting 17.92 kilowatt hour. That is approximately 18 units. Remember, I have told you 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 unit. So if your one day consumption is this, then your one day billing will be of 18 units. Now it depends on the electric distribution company of yours who is charging for the units. Say we have the distribution company in West Bengal, they are charging for like per unit, they are charging approximately 7 rupees. So they can charge 8 rupees, 9 rupees, 10 rupees. It depends on the which company is supplying electricity to your home. So approximately if I take 10 rupees per unit, then per day billing will be 180 rupees. And for a month, it will be near to 5400. So now moving on to the consumption of battery. So if you want to calculate the consumption for batteries or battery runtime, if you want to calculate, then you have to know the battery capacity. The battery capacity is mentioned on top of the battery casing. So popular unit is ampere hour. So battery capacity, if you divide it by the total current of your circuit in amps, then amps and amps gets cancelled and you get the runtime in hours. So for an example, how long a 12 volt 40 watt LED bulb will glow if battery is of 12 volt 7 ampere hour? So this 12 volt 7 ampere hour battery is mainly used in UPS and we have a load of 40 watt. So first we need to know the current. So what we'll do is load current in amps, which is I, is equal to P by V. So here power is 40 watt and voltage is 12 volt. So 40 divided by 12, the load current, that means the LED lamp or LED bulb will take 3.3 amps of current. So now if I calculate the battery runtime, then it will be the battery capacity 7 ampere hour divided by load current 3.3 amps. So it will be near to 2.1 hours. After 2.1 hours, the battery will be completely discharged. Now you may ask that if I have an entire circuit board, then how to calculate the battery runtime? It's simple. You can run the circuit through power, then calculate the overall current your circuit is taking using multimeter. You know how to calculate current, how to measure current using multimeter. If you know that, you'll then be able to estimate battery life, because you are getting the entire load current and you know the battery capacity. So divide the battery capacity by entire load current, you will get a runtime. That's it. Now many of you have asked me this: my inverter battery is of 12 volt 150 ampere hour, how long it will run? See, it is very difficult to tell, and this is not the right question. As an inverter converts DC into AC and then supplies the same AC voltage irrespective of the load, the AC power becomes apparent then. It is measured using volt ampere. In that case, to calculate the entire consumption and to calculate the battery life, I need to know three other factors, like what is the power loss and inverter output voltage is what. Sometimes inverter is giving 180 volt at output and we don't know the power factor at all. and there are some power loss. It is inevitable in case of inverter because the inverter is stepping that 12 volt up to around 220 volt. So there will be some power loss. So we don't know the power loss. We don't know the exact inverter output voltage and power factor. So it is pretty difficult to calculate. If we know all the factors, then we can calculate the same for our household. So don't ask this question to anyone because this is not the relevant question. So thanks for watching the video. If you have not subscribed to our channel, then please do subscribe. I'll come up with many interesting videos in future. Also, if you are not following me in Quora, please follow me in Quora and ask questions. You can follow BTech Bible in Facebook. The link is given in the description box. Also, click on the bell notification icon to get the latest updates.